Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.
The young armorer who was responsible for the gun that killed cinematographer Halina Hutchins on the set of Alec Baldwin's new film Rust has been careless with weapons in the past, sources allege. A source who worked alongside Hannah Gutierrez Reed, 24, on a previous film set said she has a history of recklessness around guns. She was a bit careless with the guns, waving it around every now and again, the source told the Daily Beast. There were a couple times she was loading the blanks and doing it in a fashion that we thought was unsafe. Another source accused Gutierrez Reed of loading a weapon on the Pebble Field ground and handing it to child actress, Ryan Kiera Armstrong, 11, without conducting a proper inspection. She was reloading the gun on the ground, where there were pebbles and stuff. We didn't see her check it, we didn't know if something got in the barrel or not, a source who worked with her set of the upcoming Nicolas Cage film, The Old Way, said. The individual noted that the crew waited to film until Gutierrez Reed had double-checked the barrel for obstruction. A fellow Rust crew member referred to Gutierrez Reed as being inexperienced and green, alleging that there had been at least two incidents of guns being discharged on set before Thursday's fatal accident. Rust crew members claimed there were several complaints made against the armorer on the set and that at least six fed-up people had walked off the set prior to Gutierrez Reed handing Baldwin the gun that killed Hutchins. The crew made their complaints directly to assistant director Dave Hall, who is named in the search warrant affidavit as the person handed Baldwin the gun that killed Hutchins and told him it was safe, and demanded all the discharges were documented. All of us yelled at him, that better be on the production report, these guys are irresponsible and shouldn't be here, a production source said. That should be automatic grounds for termination on a union film set, you should be gone. The first time that gun went off without telling anybody, that whole department should have been replaced, immediately. Clearly production thought better of it, decided to roll the dice and pay the ultimate price. A search warrant released Friday said that Gutierrez Reed laid out three prop guns on a cart outside the filming location, and first assistant director Dave Hals grabbed the gun from the cart and brought it inside to Alec Baldwin, unaware that it was loaded with live rounds. Cold gun. Shouted Hals before handing the gun to Baldwin, using the phrase to signal to cast and crew that the gun was safe to fire for the scene, the warrant said. Seconds later, filming a scene inside an Old West-style church, Baldwin apparently aimed towards the camera and pulled the trigger, accidentally killing Halina Hutchins as she filmed him, and injuring director Joel Souza, who stood behind her. Sources on the Rust set have said the fatal incident that killed Hutchins, 42, and injured Souza, 48, was a result of production failings from top to bottom. They added that assistant director Hals, who handed the gun to Baldwin and told him it was safe, should have checked the weapon. It's supposed to be our last line of defense and defiled us, one of the sources on set said. It's the last person that's supposed to look at that firearm. A Rust production source told the Daily Beast that there were at least two previous incidents of guns being accidentally discharged by other crew members on set before Thursday's tragic incident. The source described Gutierrez Reed as inexperienced and green. Gutierrez Reed had previously admitted she wasn't sure she was ready for the job on The Old Way in an interview before filming started. Almost didn't take the job because he wasn't sure if I was ready, but doing it went really smoothly, Gutierrez Reed said in a podcast interview last month after leading the firearms department for The Old Way, starring Nicolas Cage, her first time as head armorer. She also admitted in the podcast interview she found loading blanks into a gun the scariest thing because she did not know how to do it and had sought help from her father, legendary gunsmith Tel Reed, to get over the fear. It comes as the film crew revealed they walked off set hours before the fatal accident over safety fears after firearms were accidentally discharged three times, including once by Baldwin's stunt double who had been told the gun was not loaded, and twice in a closed cabin. Neither Hals nor Gutierrez Reed immediately returned messages from Daily Mail. Come late on Friday. Neither has been charged or named as a criminal suspect in the case, though a police investigation is ongoing. The deadly chain of events on set that led to Alec Baldwin being handed a gun with live ammunition and accidentally shooting and killing cinematographer Halina Hutchins have become clearer after it emerged last night the actor fired a live round, believing it to be a blank. Experts yesterday told Daily Mail, Com safety on set is usually extremely tight with live bullets never used in filming, and it remains unclear why a firearm loaded with live ammunition was on the Rust set at all. First assistant director Dave Halls picked up one of the firearms, a vintage-style Colt revolver laid out by armorer Hannah Gutierrez Reed, unaware it was loaded with live bullets. "Colt gun," shouted Halls before handing the gun to Baldwin, using the phrase to signal to cast and crew that the gun was safe to fire for the scene, a search warrant released on Friday said. Baldwin, filming a scene inside an Old West-style church, then fired a live round towards the camera, accidentally killing Hutchins as she filmed him. Hutchins was airlifted to the hospital but was pronounced dead. Sousa was taken to the hospital by ambulance but was released on Thursday evening. Live ammunition is never usually used on film sets, and Baldwin's shooting and killing of a cinematographer a total mystery, a Hollywood armorer said. Mike Tristan, 60, who has provided guns for movie sets for over 30 years, said the injuries sustained by Hutchins should not have been possible. Tristan, who has worked with Baldwin before, said any professional armorer would have checked the weapon, which he believes was a Western, before handing it to the 63-year-old. "There should have been blanks in the gun. The on-set armorer's job is to check that before handing the weapon over," Tristan told DailyMail.com. "They then make sure that the actor stands on a mark and never points the gun at the crew or cast. You give them a name to point at, and the editing makes it seem like they were pointing at their co-actor. That's why everyone in the industry is very confused. How this happened is a total mystery at the moment." Unionized members walked off set on Wednesday, hours before the tragedy, complaining of safety concerns. "They complained about long hours, soggy conditions, and another safety incident days earlier involving two misfires of a prop weapon." Deadline cites an Unamed source who said a gun had gone off in a cabin while someone was holding it, days prior to the shooting that killed Hutchins. "A gun had two misfires in a closed cabin. They just fired loud pops, a person was just holding it in their hands and it went off," they said, apparently referring to unintentional discharges. Baldwin's stunt double also accidentally fired two rounds after being told the firearm was cold. When they turned up to set to clear their things on Thursday, they found the white bin replaced by locals. It begs the question of who those local workers were, what their training was, and to what extent did they check the weapon before it was handed to Baldwin. The gun that fired the fatal shot was a vintage-style Colt revolver, DailyMail.com has exclusively learned. After the shooting, the armorer took possession of the gun and a spent casing, which were turned over to police, along with other prop guns and ammunition used on the set. Baldwin also changed out of the Western costume he was wearing, which was stained with blood, and turned it over to police. The warrant does not reveal the model or caliber of the prop gun that fired the fatal bullet, but the film is set in the Old West of the 1880s, and DailyMail.com has learned it was a Colt. The warrant was obtained Friday so that investigators could document the scene at the ranch where the shooting took place. Unionized workers had walked off the set hours before the fatal shooting, after they complained about long hours, soggy conditions, and another safety incident days earlier involving two misfires of a prop weapon. A yet Unamed prop master who oversaw the gun used in the fatal shooting was a non-union worker who was just brought in to replace the workers who left over safety concerns, a source involved in the movie told the New York Post. It's unclear whether Gutierrez Reed, the armorer, had recently joined the production, or was one of the crew members who stayed behind after the walk-off. However, a link in her Instagram bio points to an article about Rust from May, suggesting she had been attached to the production for some time. Unionized employees had been complaining about the fact they had to stay overnight in Albuquerque, an hour's drive from the set, and not Santa Fe because production wouldn't pay for their hotels, according to sources cited by the Los Angeles Times and multiple social media posts by film and TV insiders. When they turned up to set to clear their things on Thursday, they found the white bin replaced by locals. It begs the question of who those local workers were, what their training was, and to what extent did they check the weapon before it was handed to Baldwin. Deadline also cites an Unamed source who said a gun had gone off in a cabin while someone was holding it, days prior to the shooting that killed Hutchins. "A gun had two misfires in a closed cabin. They just fired loud pops, a person was just holding it in their hands and it went off," they said, apparently referring to unintentional discharges. Rust Production LLC did not respond to repeated requests for comment from Daily Mail. Come on Friday about the incident, but members of the union that represents many of the crew who were involved in the production said they had expressed fears about on-set safety. Baldwin first addressed the tragedy on Twitter Friday. There are no words to convey my shock and sadness regarding the tragic accident that took the life of Halina Hutchins, a wife, mother and deeply admired colleague of ours. I'm fully cooperating with the police investigation to address how this tragedy occurred and I am in touch with her husband, offering my support to him and his family. My heart is broken for her husband, their son, and all who knew and loved Halina. Then tweeted a Variety article titled Alec Baldwin was told prop gun was safe before fatal shooting, affidavit says. He was pictured doubled over in grief on Thursday after speaking to the Santa Fe County Sheriff's Department immediately following the shooting. Hutchins' husband shared a touching tribute to his wife on Twitter on Friday. Matthew Hutchins tweeted a photo of his wife and their 9-year-old son Andros on Friday caption. Halina inspired us all with her passion and vision, and her legacy is too meaningful to encapsulate in words. Our loss is enormous, and we ask that the media please respect my family's privacy as we process our grief. We thank everyone for sharing images and stories of her life. His Facebook profile picture is a photo of the couple who had been married for 16 years. His bio now reads, "Ewe miss you, Halina." A private memorial was held in Santa Fe last night with Matthew, Andros, and Baldwin in attendance, according to Showbiz 411. It was reported that grief counselors were present at the service. The grieving husband told Daily Mail, "Come on Friday morning that I had spoken with the actor. Have spoken with Alec Baldwin and he is being very supportive," I said. Zack Knight, a pyrotechnic and special effects engineer who is a member of Local 44, told Daily Mail, "Come on Friday. There should have never been live rounds on a movie set, that's number one. Number two is every single person on a movie set has a right to inspect a weapon before it's fired. And number three is, there is no reason to ever put a person in front of a weapon that's fitting. Anytime you see a movie where the barrel is pointed down the camera lens, there should not be an operator behind it. It's obvious that the considerations of this resulted in that gun being pointed directly at two people. Ewe would have additionally had a barrier between them. A large number of people filed to DOAR protocols. Every accident is a cascade of events," I said. What were happened in the moments leading up to her death, Knight said it was caused by a cascade of failures by multiple people. Ewe have a hard and fast rule that no live ammunition ever goes into a prop truck or set at any time. We just don't do it. If you see bullets on set, they are complete dummy rounds and are in no way functional. This goes back to Brandon Lee. Teres Protocol. Lee was killed in a similar incident when another actor shot him with a prop gun that was loaded with live ammunition while filming The Crow in 1993. Knight added that different gun laws between New Mexico and California may have also contributed to the accident. In California, both a trained armorer and a prop master is required on a film set and those are the standards the union adheres to as well. You will find the best and most well-trained individuals in Los Angeles. You can't guarantee that as you go across the country, I told Daily Mail. Come on Friday. Sun streaming from above, cinematographer Halina Hutchins smiles into the camera as she films herself riding off into the New Mexico desert on horseback. This was the last Instagram post shared by the married mother of one before she was accidentally killed by actor Alec Baldwin when he fired a prop gun while filming a scene for an upcoming western on a ranch near Santa Fe. Born in Ukraine and raised on a Soviet military base surrounded by reindeer and nuclear submarines, Halina, 42, had trained as a journalist and spent time in Europe working on British documentaries before making the move to Los Angeles, where she had established her career, and started a family. Remembered by friends as a kind and loving soul, Halina lived in Venice Beach, California, with her husband Matthew, a lawyer, and their son Andros, known affectionately as her little man and thought to be around 9 years old. Halina loved him so much and enjoyed watching him grow into the handsome boy he is today, one friend wrote in a moving Instagram tribute. Now she is looking after him and Matt in this horribly scary time. His social media photos capture a playfulness and sense of adventure, with Halloween costume parties, road trips with friends and days out exploring all lit up by Halina's smile. She was also highly regarded by her peers and had been tipped as a rising star by other cinematographers. She was somebody who was absolutely dedicated to art and integrity, director, colleague and friend Adam Mortimer told GMB this morning. Can tell already she was going to be a genius. Baldwin, 62, was filming a scene for new film Rose when the gun went off around 1:50 de la tarde, fatally wounding Hutchins and leaving writer-director Joel Souza, 48, injured. The incident took place at Bonanza Creek Ranch. Hutchins was rushed to the University of New Mexico Hospital in an air ambulance but was pronounced dead a short time after. Sousa was taken by ambulance to the Christus St. Vincent Regional Medical Center. He has since been released, although his exact condition is unclear. Will Stewart, Daily Mail's Moscow correspondent, told how Halina had worked for him in the mid-2000s. This is devastating and incomprehensible news about the death of Halina Hutchins. She worked for my news agency from Kyiv for several years in the mid-2000s after graduating from a local university in international journalism. Halina was involved in many stories for British newspapers and magazines, but she showed a special talent for documentaries, perhaps her first taste of film in which she went on to be so successful in America. At this time while she was with us, in 2006, she was associate producer on a documentary for Discovery Channel on Ukrainian icon Leonid Stadnik called World's Tallest Man, made by British company Wild Pictures. She was instrumental in Mr. Stadnik feeling at ease taking part in the documentary which focused on the problems of being exceptionally tall. The film, made by leading British director Richard Denton, with former BBC head of documentaries Paul Hammann as executive producer, would not have happened without her. Mary Stadnik, a seaman, trusted Halina after refusing many other film offers, and thanked her afterwards. Pictures ahead of the film shows him towering over Halina at his home in the village of Podolianci. She later went to the US with her husband Matt and accomplished great things through her UG talent and creativity but also her relentless determination to study and learn. She once told my Russian colleagues that she felt she was a perpetual student in America, but her efforts paid off and she achieved the success she thoroughly deserved. It is tragic that she died in such a cruel and inexplicable way while doing the job she so loved. Our thoughts and prayers are with Matt and their son, and Halina's family in Ukraine. Richard Denton, producer behind Shakespeare Uncovered and many films in the former USSR, said today, Halina was the most wonderful, vital, lively and positive person to work with. She was friendly and enormously helpful. She handled everything from translating interviews to making Leonid's horse move in the right direction. She was completely unpretentious and incredibly professional. Her death was senseless and stupid. Comillas sencillas.